This truck was supposed to have been done 10 minutes ago.
Gotta keep an eye on him.
Howdy, howdy. Well, that's the rainfall last night. Didn't really set us back that bad. We ended up just spending most of the day working on the combines. Some little things that just needed done, odds and ends, just literally taking all day.
It was sure beautiful last night though. I'm sure you guys liked that footage, but man,
oh, the sky was lit up. A camera never does it justice. But I've got some visitors coming. They're gonna come right along with me, so I gotta stay near the road so they can pick them up here in a second. But my buddy C gets used soon.
Say hi.
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 Are you ready to go for your tractor ride?
Yeah.
Everything's a tractor on the farm. In a couple years, he'll call it a combine. For now, it's a tractor. Okay, guys, let's get in.
Say something.
Say hi.
Hi, Grandpa.
Hi, sweetie. Back to riding the combine. Are you going to steer it?
Hi, Grandpa.
Hi, Rosie. Going to come ride with you?
What are you going to tell Grandpa?
Hi, Grandpa.
Rosie, say.
Hi, Rosie.
Say, I honk the horn.
Honk the horn.
Can you say, love you, Grandpa?
Say, bye, Grandpa.
Bye-bye. All right, bye-bye. We'll see you on the next round.
Hi, guys.
What are we doing?
Oh, look, there's a grasshopper.
Oh, grasshoppers in there.
Yeah.
I wish I had the sledge when I was a little kid. We had to sit down here on the floor of an old 7700 John Deere, and it was loud and dirty. This is the perfect spot for kids. See how happy they are?
Oh, you just crying for joy?
Whoa. Oh, there are my blinkers on. And now my blinkers on the way. Okay, party's over. Get out. Out of my combine.
Hey.
Okay, I'll help you get out. That's fun. I enjoy when they come. Get a little taste of kids before they go to bed, because I don't get to put them to bed. During harvest season, I rarely get to put my kids to bed. So it's a real treat to see them right before they go back home. That's fun. Okay, back to work.
Oh.
Wait, I was working. Back to work alone. Oh wait, you guys are watching. Okay, back to work with a couple hundred thousand of you guys. That sounds more like it. There, another day done. Got some acres cut. Not a full day. Tomorrow's Sunday, gonna be only part of a day because I gotta go to church, but we'll get some more acres cut tomorrow, and we're gonna be done with these peas in just a couple days. So, see you right now. And we're back. Ready for another day. Got back from church. It's pea cutting time. We are gonna get really close to finishing the peas today. Really close. And then I think we got winter wheat that's ready to go. So, we'll see how that goes. But anyways, I really like that logo on these combines. Wish we would've put them on last year. Looks nice. We'll be right back.
guys ever seen an alkali flat?
If you haven't, alkaline, it's like a salt from minerals from the ground, slowly gets brought up to the surface. It creates a sterile environment. There's nothing hardly grows in it except for kochia, which is our weed, which is amazing how it grows everywhere. But this sterile ground also, it leaches onto water, it holds water really tight. So it's like a swamp. Even in the driest and hottest of summers, there's mud here. See that? Yummy. I was just curious, these LSWs, how they float across it. I didn't want to go too far because frankly, I don't want to sink a combine today. But you can see my tire tracks here. Look at these bad boys. Look how wide that is. That is awesome. Isn't that amazing? I think I could drive across that thing and not fall in. I don't have a full tank of grain. Am I gonna do it? No. But there's a lot of footprint there. That's pretty cool. I gotta clean my boots off before I get back into B-spine. I don't wanna bring all that garbage up in there. Drag my feet around a little bit. Works pretty good. A few seconds of this. Between you guys and me, Leg Arms keeps begging me to drive B-spine. I won the golf tournament. He didn't. He'll get his turn. Just not in B-spine. B-spine? It's mine.
This building is 100 by 50, and I'd say this building is holding about 30,000 bushels, give or take, but that's pretty amazing. That's awesome. We're very, very blessed with what we got. Now that the building's full, we gotta move the auger, the drive over deck, over to a bin, and then we'll unload the rest of the truck because we couldn't put the rest of this truck in that building. It's a little full. All right, let's do this. Good to go. We got the auger moved. Driver pit, truck. Let's keep filling.
This is the kind of peas I like to see. 60 bushel peas right here. It's just a low spot. It just shows where, if we actually got water, what kind of yields we'd get on this farm. As of now, I believe we have under 400 acres left to cut, and we'll get a chunk of that tonight. So sometime mid tomorrow, if everything runs smooth, we'll be done with peas. These peas are doing better than we thought. I don't know, I bet it could be doing as much as 25 to 28 bushels per acre average across the board. And that's a lot better than we thought.
You want up here?
I got a passenger that wants on.
Okay, all right, I'll help you up.
Watch this. Good boy. Good boy.
He wanted a little air conditioning, so he's going to hang out with me for a little bit. Harvesting around a field like this, you gotta be careful, because when you're cutting around all those little ditches up and down all around with a 45 foot header, what happens is you're bound to drag the header somewhere and pick up this thing. That is not good for a combine. One of these bad boys, if it gets through, there's potential to do tens of thousands of dollars worth of damage. Tens of thousands, I'm not kidding. Fortunately, there is a feature on these combines. They've been around a long time. It's nothing new, but this has it, which is, we would not run without it. It's called a rock beater. The rock beater is a cylinder in there right before it enters the combine, and it's basically got bars on it, and it spins really fast, and it's just barely hitting the crop as it comes into the combine, but not hard. It's kind of whipping it past. But anything solid that comes through, it'll smack it, knocks it down into what's called the rock trap, which is a compartment that then I can pull a gate open. I'll show you in a second. Dumps the rocks in the ground. But every time I stop to dump, I want to keep an eye out because there's another rock. So you can find them in the front of the header right here. There's a spot where the rocks like to lay. As it rolls down the conveyor, it drops and stops there. So you might be able to even catch them before they even go into the combines. Let's go look at the rock trap. So the rock beater is right here. And this is my gate lever that I've moved, which is gonna get dusty, so I'm gonna jump out of the way when I do this. Hate being covered in dust. Okay, let that blow through. There we go. I shake it a little bit. That's it. Pretty simple. Do that every now and then. I probably do it about 2 times a day, depending on what kind of fields I'm in. If I know I've probably been scooping rocks, I do it more. But that way, just helps save your combine from getting absolutely destroyed. You guys remember in the spring when I was seeding and I had to take the flag off because I almost hit the power lines? I'm back there again, and this combine is definitely taller than those power lines. So I'm just carefully cutting alongside my header sticking out underneath them. I'm gonna do a pass up and down them, and that way this low spot, no one will go underneath it, and we won't snag a three-phase system and cost, I don't even wanna know how much money, and possibly damage to our combine, if not safety hazard. So they're gonna raise that pole eventually. I guess they haven't yet, but they were gonna put in a taller power pole, that way our equipment can get underneath it. But for now, gotta cut around it.
Lunchtime.
Oh yeah. How do we get you down? Never mind. He'll get himself down.
As we're cleaning the combines off, I noticed that there was a hydraulic leak. It was seeping all over up here. So I traced it up to an aluminum block that controls your auger that swings in and out. There's an access cover. I'm gonna crawl up there, open it up, and I'm gonna see if I can identify what's leaking. I believe it's just an O-ring on the aluminum block, so let's go take it apart. One of the neat things about this combine is they have access covers all around inside this hopper. So you can access a lot of different places that'd be hard to get into, squeeze into, and especially for a big guy like me, I'm not that flexible, so thank you, Case. I really appreciate that. After I took it off, I found the culprit. There's a little O-ring right here that was peeled out and the pressure was pushing it out, and so it was just leaking. I'm just gonna change the O-ring, put it back together, put it on the combine, should fix the problem. Looks like we fixed it, so next step, let's change the modules.
That's it. I think we just finished all the P's. We're done. Now we're gonna go back. We gotta change the modules out, a couple settings, change a couple bins around, move an auger or two, and we'll get into winter wheat because it's wheat time. That's my favorite part. Done with peas. Oh, these headers are gonna love us for that. Peas are hard on headers. Real low, low to the ground. Back at the farmyard. We got a new leaf blower we're gonna use, plus an air hose. And the plan is we're gonna clean off all the extra chaff and straw and everything related to peas. Open the gates up, open the elevators up, bunch of covers, just kind of get all the pea seed out of the combines and then blow them off. We're gonna have to do some work to the headers. I think I got a couple broken sections. I'm sure he does too. And then put new modules in, get them set up, be ready to roll and chop some wheat down. All right, well, combines are pretty close to being ready for winter wheat. We still got some fine tuning to do to them. Thing is, we gotta move our 82-foot auger over to the building that we're gonna be putting all this winter wheat in. So leg arms is in the 7140. I'm gonna be with Brad. We're gonna take the Fummins down there with the grain deck, get it all set up tonight so it's ready to go in the morning. And then in the morning, we'll fine tune these combines and get them ready for winter wheat as well. Let's head down the road. There. Easy peasy. Except for I left my camera up there and Brad didn't grab it. So now I gotta go get it. Just on top of the auger, recording randomness. Oh, there's that stupid camera. Turn off. Brad, you went down the wrong way. I think this is in the instructions manual to do this. Pretty sure. Okay. Let's go home. There. Done with peas. 2,000 acres down out of the 7,000. Augers at the building. Combines have the right modules in them. Got to replace a couple sections. Set them a little bit. I think we're ready for wheat. Are you guys ready? This is gonna get exciting. There's a lot coming. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless. Like and subscribe. We'll see you later. Have a good one.